Hello friends, in the previous lecture we have talked about the various that is how the covalent bond has been formed, and now we are talking about the resonance. This is a new concept that we are going to talk about in this chapter. So let us understand that is what is resonance and what are the resonating structures and what is the resonating energy. So let us talk about it. So what is resonance? This is what we have to know. So let us understand what is actually resonance. So when a molecule that can be represented by two or more structures which differ in the position of electrons and not the relative position of the atoms, and none of these structures can explain all the properties of a molecule. So this kind of phenomena that are being exhibited by a particular molecule, where we could see that the position of the atoms are remaining at their own position while talking about the electrons. The d electrons are basically delocalizing, means they can shift from one atom to another atom, and that goes on. So that kind of phenomenon that it happens, that is basically known as resonance. And it has been called that the more the resonance, then the structure or the molecule is being more stable, just like of benzene. So benzene has various resonating structures, and that's the reason that the delocalization of electron takes place in that more and compared to that of the other alkenes, if we say like butene or like propene. So that is the reason that the benzene is more stable, and this is what we are going to talk about. But talking about the resonance, resonance is the phenomenon where we could see various structures, and those structures will be very much similar, but the among if we select one of the structures, and that structure will not completely give all the properties of that particular structure or of the particular molecule. So that is what the resonating structures are. And what are those? Let me talk about that with the help of an example. Suppose we are trying to give the resonating structures of ozone. And so ozone can be represented in this way, but here I have not represented the charge over here, but I could represent the charge over here, just like we have did in the formal charge in this chapter only. So now this one will be basically the negative one, while this one will be the positive one. Again, this one will be the negative one, while this one will be the positive one. So if you observe this one, then ozone is because it is made up of basically three oxygen atoms, and one of where we could see a double bond between one oxygen and another oxygen, while one will have that is a single bond between oxygen and oxygen. So the structures, because I have named, we could name this oxygen as oxygen A, B, C. So here also it will be oxygen A, B, C. Again here also oxygen A, B and C. But let me talk about these two structures. So the position of the oxygen atoms are as it is. The only thing that has been shifting or that has been changing is basically the position of electrons, or that electrons are basically known as the localized electrons. So in this case, as we could see that there is a negative charge over here because of the extra electron that are been present on the oxygen atom, while this is the positive charge which represents that one electron has been less, or it is basically the oxygen which is electron deficient. So obviously, so as to fulfill its valency, obviously the shifting of electrons will take place over here. But while giving the electron towards this so as to form covalent bond, this oxygen will have basically four bonds, four covalent bonds. So for oxygen to form a four covalent bond, that is unstable. So obviously in that case, this pair of electrons, as we could see over here, or shared pair of electrons, they will move towards this oxygen atom, and that's the reason that we can see a negative charge over here. So therefore, these are the structures that we could observe. So let me give the structure as, suppose this is the structure number one, as this is the structure number two. And in this case, both are similar to each other. The reason behind that is, if we observe that is the distance between the oxygen and oxygen single bond, then the distance is basically found to be 148 picometer. While in this case also, we have found out the distance between oxygen and oxygen, or the bond length, and that has been found to be 148 picometer. That is what we have studied in the bond parameters. But talking about the oxygen and oxygen double bond, so we have got that is 121 picometer when it is oxygen and oxygen double bond. Here also it is 121 picometer. So now the distance between that is the oxygen and oxygen when it comes to single bond and double bond, the both are same, but the only thing is the shifting of electrons. So therefore these two structures are basically known as the resonating structures of the main ozone, and that is the reason that we will say this don't gives the whole property of the original ozone. So for that, if we observe, then this is also the structure which is very much similar to the previous two that we have mentioned over here. But this is basically known as the hybrid structure or resonance hybrid. The reason behind that is, here we could see that individually an electron shifts from one atom to another atom. But meanwhile, in this is the hybrid structure of the resonating structure, as we could see, and that which indicates that obviously the shifting of electron takes place from this atom to this atom, and it goes on And that's the reason that we know that is the distance between the oxygen and oxygen when it comes to double bond, it is basically 121. While the distance between the oxygen and oxygen single bond, it is 148. So now the resonating structure that we have got over here have a kind of similar position of the atoms. But while talking about the resonating hybrid or the hybrid structure of this one, this is the one which has a distance between 121 and 148 picometer. So now this is the most stable structure, and it also indicates we have mentioned it by that is this dash bonds. So this indicates that the electrons are been shifting very rapidly over here, and this is how the resonating structures we are representing it. So let me name this as the third structure. So now the both are basically they can be represented in any way, but the thing is this cannot give the full-on property of the ozone, while this is that is the resonance hybrid. This can give the whole information about the ozone, and that is what I wanted to talk about. And let us talk about the energy. So now let us talk about that is what is resonance energy. So resonance energy is basically the difference between the resonance hybrid structure and the resonating structures, that or we could call it as contributing structures, or we could also call it as canonical structures. So this are this one and this two are basically the canonical structures, and the difference between this hybrid structure and this canonical structure, the energy between that is basically known as resonance energy. And talking about this one, this third structure, which is nothing but the resonance hybrid, it will have lower energy, and lower the energy means more stable it is, and that is how this is more stable when we compare it with the canonical structure. So this is the resonance that I am talking about in this lecture. Previously, we have also discussed about the resonance when it comes to benzene and all. So even that is what we could follow. So thank you, friends, for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly, and you have got to know that what is the concept behind the resonance and the resonating structures and the resonance hybrid. So share this video with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.